in all the errors we have committed in ministry, it is a certain blood God saw. Somebody spoke against Moses. The earth opened and he entered. For all the archbishops and the bishops we have insulted, that we are still alive and doing ministry, it is a certain blood he saw. The sons of Eli fornicated whilst they were doing service in the temple, and they were all killed in a day, including their own father. How many of us have we not fornicated and yet we stand on the pulpit to sing? It is a bloody soul. How many of us have we not robbed him of the glory he has placed on us? And have we not traded the glory for menial things and material things? And we have traded his voice for things that have no eternal value. And yet he cried on him and he shows us mercy. It's a certain bloody soul. It's not about you. No, you have not been perfect. No, you have never been perfect. There is a blood that spoke for you. There is a blood that the eternal Father, the Father of all spirits, saw. In Jeremiah, the Bible says that, let not the rich boast in his riches, and let not the wise boast in his wisdom. But let him that boasts that he knows God, and he understands him, that he exercises judgment and righteousness and loving kindness on earth. He said, if you want anything to boast about, boast that God exercises loving kindness upon man. For his mercies are new every morning, and his compassion filleth not. Do you think you are doing well if you are saying God is wicked? Let him that boast that he knows him and he understands him, that he is the one who exercises loving kindness. When we all think that he will destroy, then he comes in and saves. Speak in tongues for 30 seconds. He is the one that has loved us. The Bible said he first loved us. Even when we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. There is a God who didn't consider who we are. When he came to die, he didn't check it. He didn't check educational backgrounds. He didn't check tribal backgrounds. He showed us mercy for who we are. Hey, for one blood that was sacrificed. Oh, Kanabasa. In the name of Jesus. Be seated. Moses. He was in the wilderness taking care of the sheep of Jethro. And then the Lord appeared to him and said, I'm sending you back to Egypt. Go and deliver my people, whom I have a covenant with, from their forefathers, Abraham. And the covenant is the covenant of circumcision. That anybody I see that is circumcised, I, God, must have mercy on him. And then Moses begins to take the journey. And the Bible said the Lord sought to kill him. And then suddenly, the wife of Moses took their uncircumcised son and then circumcised the boy and put the blood on Moses. And suddenly the Bible said the Lord refrained from killing Moses. Why? How can you be on assignment for me and your son is not circumcised? Don't you know the covenant? And the arrow of not circumcising your son is death. You are on journey for me, but I'll still kill you. After that, I'll raise another person. God saw the blood of his son. Suddenly, strength came back. I won't kill you again. The Bible said that they took the coat of many colors and they killed the lamb and soaked that garment with blood. You really want to destroy somebody and you have killed on his behalf and you have sacrificed and soaked my garment with the blood. You have attracted the God who loves to see blood. So when they sold him, another also sold him to Potiphar. Direction is going. Somebody say the blood. He enters Potiphar's house and the Bible says that and he prospered and everything he touched began to increase because God was with him. Somebody say the blood. And Potiphar's wife, Potiphar puts everything in charge, in his charge. In other words, the Bible says, except only what he will eat. The Bible says that Potiphar was the chief executioner of Pharaoh, the chief of those who kills those who have offended Pharaoh. And then this woman tries to seduce the boy. The boy runs away and then accuses the boy of rape. Among all those who killed the offenders, the chief, you try to rape his wife, and the punishment you get is prison. The Bible says he was put in a special dungeon. That was where those who commit errors in the palace are put. You committed error in Potiphar's house. What are you doing there? So he went and two people were conversing and they were sorrowful. And said, what is wrong? And they began to tell him their dreams. He said, I'm here because of dreams. It's my speciality. My brother sold me because I dream too much. Then he breaks down the dream. And watch this. The dream was between a baker, bread, and a butler, wine. Jesus, our bread. Jesus, our blood. He took the bread, lifted it up, took the wine. The blood is that which lifts people from the prison to the throne. The blood is that delivers people from death to life. The chief executioner's wife, yet I escaped it. The blood, a certain blood. And the Bible said his father kept the coat with the blood in it. If it was thrown away, it would have been another case. But the Bible said his father kept it. Why? So long as it remained with his father, the blood kept speaking for him. Let me show you. 2 Chronicles 3 verse 1. Now Solomon began to build the house of the Lord at Jerusalem on where the Lord had appeared to his father David. Have you just read that one? At the place that David had prepared on the threshing floor of Onan the Jebusite. So now a little information is given us about that threshing floor, that when the angel got there, God said, it is enough. I have remembered something. Don't continue to kill. And then the one who knew the place also saw the angel, and it was as if nothing is happening. Why? Because the threshing floor of Onan was eventually the mountain of Moriah. Have you forgotten Genesis chapter 22? God told Abraham that take down your only son, the son you love, and take him to the mountain of Moriah and sacrifice him there for me. And the Bible said Abraham took a son, and when they got to the mountain, God said, I now know you love me. I will not let you sacrifice your son, but I have prepared a lamb for myself, caught up in the thicket. And the Bible said that Abraham took the lamb and killed the lamb, and the blood of that lamb was still speaking in that place. So when the angel got there, God said, I have remembered the sacrifice. Onan knew that this is the mountain of Moriah. This is the very place that Abraham sacrificed a certain lamb, and he was about to sacrifice his son. This is the very place. If I am here, no devil, no angel. And when the angel got in between the earth, that place of the threshing floor and the heavens, God said, it is enough. What suddenly brought mercy in the heart of God? Suddenly God started having mercy. It is enough. After the revelation of the blood has come to you, sickness, it is enough. Sorrow, it is enough. Tears, it is enough. Shame, it is enough. I don't have a church here. Setbacks, it is enough. The power of sin, it is enough. Hey, addictions, it is enough. Setbacks, it is enough. Clap your hands and say, it is enough. The blood is speaking.